for a dinner and a movie. Let's head now this morning to the editorial coordinator and film critic for HollywoodChicago.com. Patrick McDonald is back with us. Hey, Patrick, good morning. Hello.
Good morning, Baker. Be safe, be healthy. Practice good karma. Wear a mask.
Yes, practicing good karma. Yes. That's a darn good idea. Sundance Film Festival, we talked about that last week. It was virtual, and you've got your top five. How was the watching?
That's right. I saw 18 films over a week.
Wow, you are a film critic.
It was the first time I was able to experience it. And I said, if I'm going to do this, I'm going to do it all the way. So here are my top five. We'll start with CODA, which stands for Child of Deaf Adult. This film focuses on the daughter of a family who's the only one who can hear, as her brother, father, and mother, played by Marley Maitland, are all deaf. Kind of started like a TV movie, but burst into an emotional expression that earned it the Grand Jury Prize at the Best Film at Sundance, and it did suck me in. Pleasure. Now, this is a harsh film about a Swedish girl who comes to Los Angeles to be a porno star. That's right. The camera never blinks to the world that is another dark level of heinous and dehumanizing human degradation. Unforgettable in its dread. Have a nice day. Jockey. Jockey's a Western-type movie substituting an old horse jockey for the cowboy. Clifton Collins Jr. plays the lead and rightly took home a jury prize for Best Actor, a glimpse into a collapsing profession, but with morality and integrity. On the Count of Three, a pitch-black comedy with real laughs and surprises as director-actor Gerald Carmichael portrays Val, a depressed dead-ender whose best friend Kevin, Christopher Abbott, has tried to kill himself while in a mental ward. Val busts Kevin out and proposes a double suicide, but first they have to have a day to make both amends and possible revenge. Follows through perfectly, and it's hilarious, by the way. And finally, my favorite film was Summer of Soul, subtitled, or When the Revolution Couldn't Be Televised. The directorial debut of Amir Khalib Questlove Thompson. This is a documentary of what was called the Black Woodstock, the Harlem Cultural Festival of 1969. Features music acts that were the cream of the crop of the era, including Young Stevie Wonder, Sly and the Family Stone, The Fifth Dimension, Glasnight and the Pips, and Chicago's own Staple Singers, among many others. The footage languished in the basement for 50 years until it was rescued as history during a prime transition from Dr. King to Black Power. Essential viewing if you want to understand the United States in 1969. Incredible.
It sounds like a really good movie.
Really is. The music alone is just enough. But the insight to what really was happening back then is the key to this one.